Our nation is at a crossroad. The right and left have never been so far divided. Major riots and violence have become the norm. Neighbor turns on neighbor, ideals and belief challenged, reminiscent of the days leading up to the Civil War. Now we look at our own state, our own country, always considered democratic, but with this population and large expanse, there is much more than one decisive option that will lead this group. Calexit presents the answer to many what-ifs facing citizens today. I am somewhere in the middle, with no bias or agenda when it comes to judging comic books. I fall not for propaganda nor peer pressure. I provide reviews based on the comic reading experience, not personal preference. And now I say to you, set your preconceived judgment aside and request Black Mask's Calexit at your local comic book store, because it's our second 10 out of 10, and it's about to get dead. Hey everybody, I'm Rick Rich Dick, host of Dick Comics for NerdRift.com, and I want to point you to yet another small-time publisher producing epic quality content. Writer Matteo Pizzolo, artist Amanke Nawapan, colorist Tyler Boss, letterer Jim Campbell, flatterer D. Cuniff, matte artist Richard Nisa, flag artist Robert Anthony Jr., and production artist Philip W. Smith make up a creative team that care and drive their passion into their work. And it pays off big time. No matter what side of the aisle you're on, Calexit number 1 is one of the best opening issues I have ever read. You need to pick up a copy today. Right now. I've read a number of politically charged comics this election year, and I have found them all to be trash. Some were rooting for the red team, some for the blue, and they were all laden with stupidity catering to their supporters. I feared Calexit would be the same, but flipping through the pages, I knew there was something different about this book. Calexit is obviously based on the idea of California leaving the United States in order to sustain itself. Technically, that can't happen. But where there's a will, there's a way. It won't happen, but it may come very close, and this comic answers the question, what if it does? California became fractured after the secession, with the United States military occupying much of it and militias popping up throughout the South. At the back of the comic, writer Matteo Pizzolo does a great job at explaining the intricacies of what's happening. The book is worth the cover price alone just for that. My only complaint about this book is that the main character is an American version of Hans Landa from Inglourious Basterds. From the attitude to finding Jews hiding underneath the floor, he's a perfect villain. But aside from a name change, there wasn't much here to make the new villain McNulty any different. McNulty is on the hunt for resistance leaders and finds that every lead offers resistance of their own. This main plot, in just one issue, takes the reader on a ride from curious and wanting to cringing and feeling. In but one issue, we have a strong villain, significant questions asked and answered, with plenty of mystery still to come, and a meaningful death from poor but warranted decisions. Our main character is not the hero. He's a courier slash smuggler who finds himself in the wrong place at the wrong time quite often. He is smart enough to create an all-knowing bird by attaching a smartphone AI to a drone, and he is charismatic enough to stay on the good side of every faction in the city. He is the kind of roguish devil you need to guide you through a dystopia such as this. If you watched our last video, take a moment to compare the overdone dystopia slash utopia conflict of Skin and Earth versus the world falling apart dystopia of Calexit. They've both been done before, but because we're offered a viewpoint from characters on all sides of the conflict, Calexit comes across as new and fresh. The tone is set from page one, and this feels like a real world. In fact, one that we could be living in just a few years from now if we aren't careful. All right, enough gushing on the story and world setup. Let's look at how this artwork almost feels disjointed from the story, weaving its own tale. Yet the two come together to paint something bigger, with layers. And between the artwork and plot point is real banter between flawed characters that are just trying to get by in this miserable existence. You might even catch a couple good jokes in there. So yes, Calexit number 1 receives a 10 on the Richter scale, because it's got everything. Not just what you need to kick off a story, but it goes beyond. There's role reversal, laughs, tears, and you need to check it out. If your local comic shop doesn't carry Black Mask, make them. Or buy the issue on comixology.com. Link is in the description below. Comment below on your thoughts about this book. Find more comic book reviews on nerdrift.com. Remember to like and share this video, hit subscribe, and spread the word so we can make more and better videos in the future. And come back next week for more.
Dead.
This is the second book in a row where a guy told a girl she had balls and she responded with, "They're called ovaries." What?